हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मनीष महर्षि, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट डूंगर कॉलेज, बीकानेर. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द विक्टोरियन पीरियड ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विथ विक्टोरियन एज, आई वुड जस्ट लाइक टू क्विकली ग्लॉस ओवर द अदर एजेस एंड पीरियड्स ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. After the Dark Ages, the first major age of English literature is Age of Chaucer, named after the father of English poetry, Geoffrey Chaucer. And other notable poets of this period were William Langland, John Barber, and John Wycliffe. Then we see one of the most important movement of world history, which completely changed the gestalt, or one should say, the dimension of human existence. This movement is known as Renaissance, which placed the human being at the center of universe, which was earlier occupied by God, or one can say the religion of the world, the organized religion of the world. It was the revival of the ancient learning that gave rise to humanism in Europe and later in the whole world. Then came the Elizabethan period in English literature. Some of the most important literary artists belonged to this period, such as Marlowe, Shakespeare, Francis Bacon, Edmund Spenser. England in this period was known as Singing Bird. From 1603 to 1660, we see the Puritan age in English literature and metaphysical movement. The period is subdivided into Jacobean and Caroline age. In the Puritan poetry, John Milton is one big name who wrote the only English epic, Paradise Lost. John Donne came as a fresh air in the English poetry and heralded the metaphysical movement of poetry, which had its features in the prose of that time. Later on, after Restoration from 1660 to 1700, we see the Neoclassical Age, also known as Augustan Age. The main writer of this period are John Dryden, Alexander Pope, Samuel Johnson, essayists like Addison and Steele. There is a rise in the writing of novels in this period, and notable novelists like Richardson, Somerset, Sterne, Fielding, Goldsmith and Sheridan's. Then there are pre-romantics and romantics. Pre-romantics are also known as transitional poets, as we see that they have the features of their earlier age and also the some of the features which belongs to the future age of romantics. The major pre-romantic poets were Thomas Gray, William Cowper, William Blake, Robert Burns and James Thomson. Later on, we see some of the best poets in English literature who belong to Romantic period: William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, John Keats, Shelley, and Byron. All these poets were highly influenced by the French Revolution of 1789 and the philosophy of Rousseau and his statement, "Man was born free, but everywhere he is in chains." There is a significant presence of nature in the poetry of all romantic poets. Charles Lamb and William Hazlitt, D. Quincey are among the major essayists of this period. Sir Walter Scott, Bulwer Lytton, Thackeray are the major novelists. Jane Austen is one of the prominent novelists of this period. According to the time periods, these ages can be divided into following dates. The age of Chaucer starts from 1350 to 1400. Then we see the 15th century literature, where we see the coming of printing press and religious poetry and drama like mystery plays and morality plays. Then there is Renaissance period, which starts from around 1485 to 1560 Puritan age starts from 1603 to 1660, the Restoration era 1660 to 1700, 18th century or neoclassical period from 1700 to 1798. Romantic period starts from 1798 to 1850, and Victorian period 1850 to 1900. As we see that these periods are divided into these dates, but there is some spilling over of the periods from one period to another. One of the most important thing which we should discuss in a little brief is the Renaissance movement, because it is the one movement which gave rise to the world we see today. This movement, which starts with the fall of Constantinople in 1453 and later on it was given impetus by the invention of printing press, new scientific discoveries and inventions. It heralded the end of the medieval world and the starting of the modern age. The revival of the ancient learning, which in various ways widened the horizon of the people of that time. All these factors together gave impetus to the rise of humanism. The term humanism is very important to understand for us, as it is because of this rise of humanism the new world is going to take its shape, and it took its shape and roots from humanism. Humanism is in a very basic manner can be understood as placing the human being in the center of the world and everything else at its periphery. Before this, God and organized religion was at the center of the universe. Whatever human beings were doing was devoted to the God and not for its own sake. One is earning for God. His income was devoted to God. In that sense, it was under the church of that time, whatever sort of organized religion there existed. Even literature of any kind existed. It was didactic and religious in nature. So the life of the people of that time was completely associated with religion, and the head of these religious organizations enjoyed their prime state. But with the rise of the humanism, for the first time in European history, man was placed at the center of the existence. His life is revered for its own sake. He was enjoying the creation of the God. This gave encouragement to the human mind to search different places and different things to make his life better. He started working hard to improve his state, which gave rise to all the things we see now. So the simple act of changing the position of human being acted as the seed of the modern man. Hello friends,